Good afternoon. My name is Monica Valentine, and I work here at the Library of Congress. All day here at the Library of Congress National Book Festival, we are recognizing and celebrating the importance of reading and authors and books. The Library of Congress makes it seem easy to do this every year, but the truth is the National Book Festival is a huge undertaking. It is a huge financial undertaking, and it is free for everyone because of the generous support from our sponsors and supporters. Spread the joy of reading with your gift online at loc.gov/donate from the festival app or when you purchase books today. Now, on to the main event. It is my pleasure to introduce the author of one of the most popular book series in our Library of Congress Young Reader Center, The Dork Diaries. We first met everyone's favorite dork, Nikki Maxwell, in 2009. Since then, Rachel Renée Russell has published 12 Nikki Maxwell tales, and the 13th, Tales of a Not-So-Happy Birthday, is due out on October 16th. She sold over 30 million copies of this New York Times bestselling series and the Max Crumbly series. Be sure to visit the book sales area today where you can pick up her books. Here to share more with us about Dork World, we welcome Rachel Renée Russell and Nikki Russell. And Nikki Russell.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm happy to be here. Yay! We'd like to welcome you to the National Book Festival. And this is, I think, our fourth or fifth time here. And we love coming and, you know, seeing all you guys. And it's a fantastic book festival, one of our favorite. So standing next to me is the namesake for Dork Diaries. Her name is Nikki Maxwell. Well, this is my daughter, Nikki Russell. And not only was Nikki and my older daughter, Erin, the inspiration for Dork Diaries, but Nikki illustrates it now. So we're going to start off by talking a little bit about Dork Diaries. We're going to do a dramatic reading of my favorite chapter in Dork Diaries, book 12. And then at the end of that, we're going to have a Q&A. So if there's any questions you'd like to ask, we'll take questions, and then Nikki's going to try to squeeze in a couple of dorkifications. And the dorkifications is when she will actually draw a few people out of the audience as a Dork Diaries or Max Crumbly character. So we'll be doing that at the very, very end. So we have a lot to try to get into our presentation. So I'm going to have a seat. And Nikki, you going to sit down or are you going to draw?
Draw.
Okay. Nikki's going to draw. Okay, what you're seeing now is the Dork Diaries series, and at the bottom right is Dork Diaries book one, and then we've gone all the way through since 2009 to our newest book, and that's Dork Diaries book 12. And that this one came out in October of 2017, and our newest book will be coming out October 2016 in just a few more months. The brand new series that we launched a couple of years ago is The Misadventures of Max Crumbly. And there's a video that...
Let's try that again. This is Max Crumbly, super-powered eighth grader at Southridge Middle School. All right, fine, Max doesn't have superpowers, but if he could give himself superpowers with weird glowing potions, the first person he'd rescue is... himself. Because the truth is, Max Crumbly's life stinks. We're talking stinks worse than Dark Thurston, and that's gas mask level stink. In just 2 weeks, Max has the record for most tardy slips in a single hour, earned the nickname Barf after a rope climbing mishap in PE, and has been crammed in his locker by Thug Thurston about 8 bajillion times. The thing is, Max could be a hero. He'd go around saving the world with his wicked raps, rescue Aaron Madison's school play with his awesome art skills, and maybe, just maybe, even hone his serious bladder control issues for good. Yep, Max Crumbly could be a hero. But first, he'll need to survive a 3-day weekend crammed in his locker. Find out what happens in The Misadventures of Max Crumbly, a new series by Rachel Renée Russell, author of the number one best-selling series, Dork Diaries. Out now.
Thank you. So just a little bit about Max Crumbly. Max is about to face the scariest place he's ever been, South Ridge Middle School. There is a lot that's great about his new school, but there's also one big problem. Thug Thurston, also known as Thug, the school bully whose hobby is stuffing Max inside his locker. If only Max could be like the hero of his favorite comics. Read The Misadventures of Max Crumbly One Locker Hero just to see how much of a hero Max can be. So this was our first book in the Max Crumbly series. We've also written and released a second one, and that's Max Crumbly Book 2, Middle School Mayhem. And we have a little mini video for that one.
All right, so my job is to tell you a little bit about Max Crumbly, Book 2, Middle School Mayhem. When we last left our hero, Max Crumbly, he had crash-landed on top of a mighty meat monster pizza after taking a late-night tumble through the vents at South Ridge Middle School. And he was completely surrounded by three ruthless criminals. Will Max be shredded to bits like mozzarella cheese on the hard and crunchy pizza crust of doom? Or can his friend and sidekick computer whiz Aaron help get him out of this sticky situation alive? Find out in The Misadventures of Max Crumbly 2, Middle School Mayhem.
And our new book, which is coming out on October 16th, is Dork Diaries, Tales of a Not-So-Happy Birthday. Nikki Maxwell is finally getting ready to celebrate her birthday. So again, this book will be coming out October 16th, and you can pre-order it. Otherwise, you can buy it on October 16th on the release date. And again, it's will be released on October 16th, and we're back with the normal cast of characters. We have Nikki, and of course, her two BFFs, Zoe and Chloe, will be helping her to plan the party. Mackenzie will be there trying to ruin her birthday. And then, of course, we have her crush, Brandon. And then there's wacky Brianna, her little sister. So we'll have the entire cast back for Dork Diaries Book 13, Tales from a Not-So-Happy Birthday. Okay, the next thing I'm really excited about, and this is our first time trying this, we're going to do a short reading from my favorite chapter of Dork Diaries Book 12. It's this book here, and it's the diary entry of Nikki Maxwell, which is Sunday, May 25th. And if you have the book and you'd like to follow along, it's going to start at about page 67. Nikki's going to be, I'm going to be Nikki Maxwell, and I'll read her parts. Nikki is going to do a dramatic interpretation of Brianna, Mom, and Dad. So I'm going to set things up a little bit. Nikki and her family are eating lunch together, and Nikki's favorite television show is a reality show called My Rich and Trashy Life, and it's about these sisters that are very, very wealthy, and they always have drama going on in their lives. So, and again, it's based off of a real live reality show, but in Dork Diaries, Nikki is really into watching that reality show. So as soon as she finishes lunch, she wants to rush off and watch her favorite reality show. But her mother has other plans. Her mother has decided that it's family game board afternoon. So she wants the entire family to sit down and play a game board. So we'll start with that.
Is everybody ready for fun, fun, fun?
I wanted to watch my favorite reality show, but no, Mom wanted us to have family game time. Brianna came skipping into the room with a small bag behind her back and an old pizza box covered in finger paint and glitter.
Look at this! I made my own game, and it's called Brianna's Funnest Game Ever! You're gonna love it! Can we play it? Can we, Mommy? Please?
Brianna pleaded.
We'd love to play your game, sweetheart.
Mom smiled.
It's going to be fun.
Brianna opened her pizza box. Inside was a handmade game board with random squares and colorful crayon scribbles that made no sense whatsoever. I couldn't tell which direction to move or where the finish line was. It looked like Brianna had just chewed up some crayons and spit them out on the paper with her eyes closed.
Okay, I'm gonna be the boss. Daddy, you can be the paperclip, and Mommy, you can be the penny.
She handed them their game pieces. Cool, I get to be the cute Barbie shoe, I smiled. I picked up the tiny pink sparkly high heel.
Nuh-uh, that's mine. Remember, it's my game. I made it, so I'm the boss of it.
Then she stuck her tongue out at me. I folded my arms and glared at her. Then what am I supposed to use to play your game? There's nothing left, I grumbled. Brianna checked inside the box, and sure enough, there weren't any more game pieces. But she just shrugged her shoulders at me like it wasn't her problem. That's when I got a brilliant idea. Oh no, Brianna, it looks like I won't be able to play your game. I'm so disappointed. I pretend pouted like I was about to cry. I guess I'll just have to go and watch the finale of My Very Rich and Trashy Life while you guys have all the fun. But I'll get over it. Bye.
Hey, wait a minute.
Brianna grinned as she peeled off a moldy piece of pepperoni that was stuck to the bottom of the pizza box.
Here, Nikki, this is your game piece.
Ew, I shrieked. I don't want that nasty thing.
But it's the best one. If you get hungry and want a snack, you can chew on it. Then, when it's your turn to move again, you just put the pepperoni back on the game board. I bet you can chew it for just hours, like gum.
That's when I threw up in my mouth a little. Mom, I whined, waiting for her to intervene.
Nikki, you're spoiling the fun. Brianna worked really hard on this game, so simmer down. Just take the pepperoni and try to be a good sport, okay?
I begrudgingly picked up my nasty pepperoni, trying to avoid the fuzzy mold, and dropped it on the start box. It was misspelled stat.
Mommy, you go first.
Mom rolled the die and moved four spaces.
Now this is the fun part. You have to do whatever the card I choose during the game says.
Brianna squealed and pulled out a stack of index cards written in black marker in her sloppy handwriting. However, instead of taking a card from the top of the stack, Brianna quickly sorted through them until she found one she liked.
Here, Mommy, this is your card.
Mom read the card.
You are nice and pretty like Princess Sugarplum. Move forward seven spaces.
How sweet. This game is fun.
Okay, Daddy, your turn.
Dad rolled the die and moved five spaces. Then Brianna selected a card for him. Dad read,
today is your lucky day. Do the hokey pokey and then move ahead six spaces.
Woohoo!
Dad exclaimed. He hopped to his feet and did a rendition of the hokey pokey that included the chicken dance and some moves he stole from a Justin Bieber video. Ugh, now I'll never be able to watch that video again without thinking of Dad's hokey pokey. Next, it was my turn. I tossed the die and moved three spaces.
Uh-oh,
Brianna said, reading the card she had selected to me. She handed it to me and then read it out loud.
You are ugly and eat boogers. You lose a turn. Sorry.
What? I shouted. That's not fair. Why do I have to be the ugly, booger-eating loser?
Because it's my game and I make the rules.
Brianna said all snotty-like with her hand on her hip. Okay, fine, I grumped. I thought this was supposed to be fun. I was so over Brianna's stupid game.
Yay, everybody, it's my turn.
Brianna giggled. She rolled the die and moved her Barbie shoe three spaces.
Now I get a card,
she said as she quickly sorted through the stack until she found one she liked.
Oh, goody, my card says, you are the bestest player and get to have three pieces of candy from the jackpot candy stash. Congratulations!
What? What do you mean? What jackpot candy stash, I exclaimed.
This one,
Brianna answered as she grabbed the plastic bag and opened it. I almost had a heart attack. Inside was my precious candy stash. That bratty little thief has snuck into my room and stolen my entire stash of candy. No way, I protested. I hate this cruddy game. Give me back my candy stash, Brianna. Give it back now.
Aw, come on, Nikki. It's just candy. You can always get more. Let's just try to have fun playing your little sister's game.
I agree. This is an opportunity for you to be an excellent role model for Brianna. So try not to be a sore loser. Listen to your father and your mother.
My mom admonished me. It's no wonder I had a really bad attitude about the whole thing. Every time it was my turn, I ended up with a stupid card that said something like,
you got cooties without a cootie shot. Go to jail. Sorry.
Or,
you stinks really bad, need a bath. Go back to start and then lose a turn. Sorry.
And whenever it was Brianna's turn, she got to eat several more pieces of my candy. I just sat there glaring at the three of them in complete disgust. I couldn't believe I was being forced by my very own parents to watch my bratty little sister eat my entire candy stash during the finale of my favorite reality show, My Very Rich and Trashy Life. I was very tempted to call the authorities and report them for child abuse. Finally, Brianna had an ingenious plan to get her grubby little hands on my property, my candy stash. But by the end of the game, my sister had eaten almost half of my candy. She had chocolate all over her face and hands and was looking a little queasy.
Oh, my tummy. Mommy, I don't feel so good.
Goodness, I think this game has gotten completely out of hand,
my mom said, looking a bit flustered. Dad scooped Brianna up off of the floor.
You've had way too many sweets, young lady. I think you need to go get some rest to cure that tummy ache.
But I want to keep playing,
she whined in a weak voice.
I never get to eat as much of Nikki's candy as I want.
Aha! Just as I had suspected, the whole point of Brianna's stupid game was to get into my candy stash, and my mom and dad had fallen for it. I'll give Brianna points for being a pigtailed evil genius in pink My Little Pony sneakers. But I refuse to feel sorry for her. The next time we have a board game madness night, we're going to play a rigged game my way. My board game is going to be called Broccoliopoly, and it'll feature all of the foods that Brianna hates. Watch your back, little sister. You're going to get a big, green, nasty payback, and it's going to be healthy. I can't wait to give Brianna a special card from my game that's gonna say,
today is your lucky day. You get to drink a gallon of green smoothie. Sorry? Oh, Nikki, I hate your game.
And who knows, if I'm feeling really vengeful, I might just toss in some moldy pepperoni for extra flavor. Mm-hmm. 4 minutes, okay. Okay, now we're going to do a really quick Q&A. So if you have a question, you can line up. I think there's microphones back there. Okay, we'll go back and forth, okay.
What was your inspiration for the Brandon crush?
The inspiration for Brandon crush was actually my older daughter, Erin. When she was in middle school, she had a tremendous crush on a guy, but the entire year she never said one single word to him. So the relationship between Brandon and Nikki is kind of a fantasy of if she had was able to talk to her crush, what it may have been like. So Brandon is inspired by a real life person.
What is your favorite Dork Diaries book that you wrote?
My favorite Dork Diaries book is always the newest one. So right now it's this one, Dork Diaries book 12. And more than likely, once we release Dork Diaries book 13, that will probably be my favorite. And I think it's because I spend a year writing them and then you just kind of get attached to it since you're working. And you can ask Nikki a question too.
How many more books do you think you're gonna write?
I will keep writing Dork Diaries books as long as you guys keep reading them. So at this point, I see no end in sight. And we're working on Dork Diaries book 14 now, and 13 will come out in October. So I'll be at it for many more years to come as long as you guys keep reading.
How many books are you planning on having?
I'm going to keep writing forever and ever and ever. So, yes, at this point, there's no end in sight.
Where did you get the inspiration for Brianna?
The inspiration for Brianna was actually Nikki. When Nikki was a little kid, she was very active, I'll put it that way. And she was like taking apart the television and writing on the walls, and she was very, very busy, and she was very curious, and she had a wacky sense of humor. So definitely Nikki is the inspiration for Brianna.
Why did Nikki have the crushes?
Nikki had crushes because a lot of times by the time you get in middle school and you start high school, you start noticing guys and girls in your classroom and you start having crushes. So we decided to give Nikki Maxwell a crush because that's kind of what happens when you're in middle school.
What's your inspiration for each story you write?
Each book has a theme. Like for example, Dork Diaries book 1 was Nikki entering an art show, and that actually happened because Nikki and Erin have both entered art competitions. The one with the music was inspired because when I was a little girl, we had a girl band, my sisters and I, and we actually performed at the Apollo Theater. So Dork Diaries book 3 was based on that. And so anyway, all of the books are based on things that have happened to either myself or my daughter. So they're kind of based on real life. So we'll just take one more question.
What was your inspiration for the first Dork Diary?
The inspiration for the first Dork Diaries was inspired by my two daughters, Erin and Nikki. And growing up, they were really tall because their dad is like 6'4". So they were really tall and kids gave them a hard time and teased them and bullied them because they were so tall. And a lot of times, like if a parent came in to visit, they would mistake Erin or Nikki for a teacher's aide or another adult, and they were like only fifth or sixth grade. They just were really, really tall for their age. And since they got teased, I thought if I ever wrote a children's book, I would try to talk about bullying and dealing with mean girls and how to cope with them, and that would make it really funny and inspire kids to hang in there and deal with the situations in case they're experiencing that same type of thing. So I think we're all done now.
All right, so I have two pictures I was able to do during this very short, sweet time we had together. The first is a dorkification of a young lady seated front and center with the most adorable red headband on and bow. Would you like to come up and get your dorkification? And the next artwork we have, thank you, Mommy. The next artwork we have is a crumblification of a gentleman here to the far left in a gray American flag t-shirt. Come on up and get your crumblification. Come on. There you go. I wish I could draw many, all of you, but I'm afraid we ran out of time for that. So please give these two a round of applause.
Okay,
thank you.
You can have a seat. You can have a seat, dear.
Okay, you can have
a seat. Okay, we're going to be signing books. Is it what time? Was it 1 o'clock? What time are we signing? Anyway, we're going to be signing books shortly after this, and we have lots of free stuff because we love you guys. So we have a Dork Diaries Book 12 gumball machine, and it has colorful gumballs and a Dork Diaries sticker, and it matches our cover. And we have stickers and bookmarks and Max Crumbly stickers and a lot of fun stuff. So we're looking forward to seeing you guys when we sign books. Love you guys.
Hope to see you soon at the book signing.
Always remember to let your inner dork shine through and be the hero you've always admired.